Hey guys, Jacqueline here, and welcome to How to Make a 2D RPG in Unity. This is my first full game tutorial series where I'm going to go through and show you how to create a game from start to finish. So this is kind of like real talk moment for me because I'm going to actually just show you the exact process that I go through. We're going to start by just making some basic mechanics and like our dialogue system and moving our character around, all of those things, and getting those things working outside of, you know, the story of an RPG. And then we'll go and turn to creating the story, and I'll show you my process for that, as well as creating characters, and just putting all of those things together to create an actual RPG experience. So the goal for this project is to create maybe like half an hour to an hour of gameplay, just do like a little snippet of an RPG, just to get you comfortable in creating these systems and learning how to solve the problems that you need to solve in order to make an RPG. So that is kind of the goal of this tutorial. So let's get started. The first thing that you want to do is open up Unity. If you don't have Unity installed, you can go to the Unity website and download it. But once you have that, you'll want to open up the hub and make sure that you have 2020.3.25 F1 installed. So that is a Unity version. It's actually the latest long-term support from Unity, and this will be supported into the foreseeable future. Nothing in this build is going to change, and everything that works for this inside my tutorial will work for this version like forever. If you don't want to use 2020.3.25F, then feel free to use whatever version that you want. Just keep in mind that things may be different. I might have settings that you don't have, or they might be in different places. So just keep that in mind as you continue. So the first thing that we want to do is go ahead and just create a brand new project. I'm going to set it as 2D, and I'm going to name it, I'm just going to name it 2D RPG. I don't really have a name for it since I don't have a story in mind yet. But we're going to work on that together. And then I'm going to just save it to my desktop inside of, I'll create a new folder for it. So 2D RPG, create, and then just select the folder. And then once you have all of that selected, you can go ahead and create projects. So this is going to take a second. It's going to build and import all of the things, and then it's going to open up Unity for me. So once this is done opening, I will meet you back here. Okay, so Unity has opened up, and we're going to start off with a screen that looks just like this. Yours actually might be like the light version. So if it looks just a different color, there's a setting in here that you can change it to dark version. I'm not going to go through how to do that, but just keep in mind that that is why this might look a little bit different than yours. But generally, we should have about all of the same things. So let's just go through real quick for those complete beginners out there and just explain like Unity and how we're going to go ahead and use it and get comfortable inside of the editor. So starting over here at our very left-hand side, we have a tab called Hierarchy. And this is all of the things that is inside your scene. So this is like a list of all the things that you are putting into your game. So like if we right click, we can create, let's say we want to create a square sprite. So you'll see that pop up here, and you also see it inside of your game. So by clicking on this, you can manipulate it. We'll go through how to do that in more detail in a minute. But this is just kind of a list of everything that you have in your scene. So if we put another square in there, now we have two squares, and we can see two squares here. This is going to be how you can select things and edit them, and how do you keep track of, you know, what's in your game. So I'm going to go ahead and delete one of those, I guess. So that is your hierarchy. So the next group that we have here, the scene tab, is how you can like physically manipulate the objects that are in your scene. So by clicking on the hierarchy, you can select an object, and then these handles will probably show up by default for moving left and right. So you can just click and drag them in order to move your square around. You can also There's this blue square here. You can drag that to click and drag it to move it both on the X and on the Y axis to move it like any direction, where this one only lets you move up and down on the Y, and clicking on the red handle only lets you move X and Y. So if I go up and down, it doesn't go up and down, it only goes back and forth, left and right. Cool. So that is how you move that around. So this scene view lets you manipulate everything in your scene. It lets you physically move things or put things in or rotate things. So to rotate, you can press the E key on your keyboard, or you can click this little button up here that changes which tool that you're currently using. I generally use a lot of the hotkeys, so you'll probably hear me like, "Oh, I'm pressing E now." So E switches you over to this rotate handles tool here. So the X is the red, so if we want to rotate it on the X axis, so we can turn that over and that'll rotate it on the X axis. And we could rotate it on the Y axis, so this is the green. So really what this is doing is if we rotate it on the X, if this is the X axis, it's rotating around that X axis. For the Y, it's going to also rotate around, so it's going to rotate up and down. In 2D games, we're going to mostly rotate on the Z axis, which is this blue circle, which lets us rotate it kind of like as if we're looking at down on a piece of paper and turning like a bottle cap or a die, like just turning it this way. So this is going to be the rotation that we're going to use a lot in the game for movement and such like that. We won't be using the X or the Y in a 2D game, like probably not, most likely not. Okay, so after the rotate, we also can resize our square. So if you press the R key, it'll change it to these, or you can click on the resize tool up here on this button, and pulling on the Y will resize it on the Y, so you can make it bigger or smaller. You can do the same thing for the X, or you can also zoom in and you can grab the center. It's like a white dot, so it's hard to see, but you can resize both axes at the same time. So that's a super useful tool. And then if you click on, I think it's T, yep, T, you'll get this like transform box here where you've got the blue handles. That's also if you click the rect tool up here. It's the fourth one from the left, and it has the kind of dots on the side. This also lets you resize and like reposition the object. So you wouldn't really use this in a 3D game, except for maybe with like UI or 2D elements in your 3D game. In a 2D game, you can use it pretty much whenever you like. I'll typically use like this sort of thing when I'm like resizing. Instead of the R tool in 2D, it just kind of depends on like what I'm doing. But it's also a useful tool. All right, and then if you want to do all of the things at once, there is a tool for that. So I don't ever use this. I don't know why you would ever use this, but it's there for you. And then they also have a custom mode, so we're not going to get into that right now, but you could also check out creating t custom tools for the future. All right, so with that being said, that is our scene view, and that's kind of how you move around and manipulate the objects in the scene. There is also a camera in which you view the world through. So that is, let me put that back. So you'll see that I can drag it around. I can zoom in and out. And you can also actually rotate the camera as well. In a 2D game, we're really not going to do that. So if we click out of 2D mode, you can see that there you could like fly around and move the camera and rotate it. But since we're in 2D, we won't ever be doing that. We're going to stay in 2D mode. So really all you can do is drag. So if you right click and move the mouse, you will drag the screen around. You can view different parts. And then if you use your scroll wheel, you can zoom in and out. And that's really everything about the game scene that we need for, or the scene view that we need right now. And we'll be continuing to use this, so it'll become like second nature. All right, so our next view is our game view. And sometimes these are dragged onto each other like this, where you have two scenes. I typically work with mine side by side, just so I can see what's happening over here while I'm working over here. But the game view shows us what the camera sees, what the player is going to see when they play the game. So you can see this camera here in the hierarchy. If we were to move this, the view over here is going to change inside of our game view, because the game view is literally what the camera can see. So we're going to put this back to its original location at 0, 0. And we won't ever probably move the camera around like personally in the scene view. We'll probably have it, following our player around, and we'll kind of get to that. But the camera will pretty much just leave alone. And we but if you would like, you can also move it around just like you could any other game object inside your scene view. And then the game view just displays what the camera sees. So that's helpful for when you're trying to figure out like what it looks like or setting up like a particular sequence, all of those fun things. Then going to our right, we have our inspector. And you'll notice when you click on a game object in your hierarchy, your inspector will change. And it'll change to show you all the information about the game object that you have selected. So here I have my square selected. You can see that it has a transform that shows us its position in the world. So right now it's at negative 2.59, negative 0.129. We can actually just change those values to be 0 to put it back at 0, 0. We also can see its rotation. So if you were to just put in a number here, we could rotate it on the X, Y, or Z. So we could put this at like 45 and we'll rotate that. And then we also have its scale, and this is going to change like its size. So by default, this is its normal size, is 1, 1, 1. Things can't really have a scale of 0. If you give it a scale of 0, it will be gone. You won't be able to see it. A scale of 1 is like its regular size, what the size of the thing that you put it in the scene. So if you were to put like a picture or a sprite in, a scale of 1 would just be its the size that the actual asset is. And then if you were to change it, like say 0.5, then it would be half the size. If you say 2, it would be twice the size on that particular axis. So we'll probably use some of these things. If you put a scale to, let's say, negative, it'll actually like flip the sprite, like kind of mirror it. So we might use some of those tricks as well. And then this sprite has a sprite renderer. This is allows us to see the sprite inside of the scene. It renders it for us basically, and we can change the color on the sprite renderer. So let's say we want to make the square green, or we can make it orange or purple, really whatever we want. All right, so another important part of the inspector is the add component button. Here you will find a whole bunch of different components that we can add to our game objects. I would definitely recommend just going through and taking a look at some of them, seeing what types of things that we could do. We're not particularly going to use mesh because we're not using 3D, but like 2D animations we'll get into, and we're not going to be adding any of this directly probably like for a while. So you can take a look and see like physics 2D. This is all the physics things, lots of new things. And as we create scripts, they'll also be available for us to add inside of here. So great. Then, going to the bottom half of our screen, we have our project view where we can see all of the files inside of our project. So, currently, we have a single folder called Scenes with a sample scene, which is the default scene. We'll end up renaming this and setting up a whole different scene. And here we'll be adding our various folders that we need to like keep track of our data. So, like having like a folder for scripts and a folder for our assets and a folder for animations to keep our assets folder organized. We can find it, what we're looking for easily. Then, next to the project tab, there is the console tab. This is the output log for all of the code. Here you'll see if you have any errors with your code or things not working properly in the scene, as well as if we want to write anything to the log for testing, they'll show up here. All right, so that is Unity. I think the only thing left is learning how to play your scene. So if you're ready to see how your scene looks or works, you can test it out right here in the editor. There's this play button up here. You can press that, and it will essentially start your game from the scene that you're currently in. So since we're in the sample scene, we'll start there. If, let's say, we have a few different levels or a few different scenes, and it requires you to start from a specific scene, you'll have to like navigate to that scene and then hit play, and then you'll be able to play your game as if you had started it up on your computer in a build. So that is Unity. I hope that wasn't too confusing. I do urge you to like check this out, play around, try to add sprites to the scene, try to change their color, and just like maybe mess around, add like a rigid body 2D to one to see what happens. In the next video, we're going to set up our character controller for our 2D RPG guy. I'm gonna show you where you can find some free cool assets and really make this game your own.